I would like to see what you have in stock.
I can get you that one easy. This will serve you well. Done for now.
I must be on my way now. Goodbye.
Be well, my friend.
Finnum dir gripat.
Man your oars. Let's hear a story.
When I was 11 winters old, I was the youngest of my favorite cousins. A wild and rowdy bunch of boys and girls. Together with our parents, we attended a feast at the home of Halfdan the Black of the House of England. To toughen our patience, us to bake flatbreads and serve it to the noble yards. After enough, piled so high into pillars, you could have built a roof over it and called it a longhouse. When our work was done, an older boy, Guthrod, suggested we steal a keg of mead, drown in happiness for our good work. So Guthrod, Mikkel, and Orsa snuck into the storeroom and stole a barrel as
More
I stood
sail!
Watch. But when we were spotted, I froze. Three of Harald's men stopped us. They struck Guthrod and Mikkel and pushed Orsa to the ground. Whose idea was this? They asked. I stood and said, the idea was mine. The mead is for me. One of the men eyed me and said only, that is not true. Then, they moved on.
Save my ravens. Is there a sea skull among you?
There was a woman called Nal, who came by ship to Hornburg and Harald, demanding to meet King Sigvaldi, Styrbjorn's father. Nal was from Gautland. She was tall and rugged and strong. Everyone who walked near her said she smelled of men's blood. When her message was sent to our king, Nal was made to wait a full day. Yet she did not complain. She watched the waves and sang songs. Night came and went, and still Nal sat by the shore of the fjord, singing her songs. She skipped rocks with children and smiled. As the afternoon of the second day approached, King Sigvaldi's messenger reappeared. They spoke quietly together. At last, the messenger stood back and waved to some men nearby. Three men bearing three chests of silver approached. Of silver in Gnarl's ship and stood back. Then Gnarl stepped forward, swinging a large bloodied sack before her. Gnarl opened the sack and emptied it on the shore. Seven pairs of hands tumbled to the ground. Gnarl then mounted her ship and sailed away.
Sackler!
What are you doing?
Lord,
you there! A word!
Rurona Paterosa.